month of May, to Carlisle he did come, a gentle and a courteous child that knew much wisdom, a tunic and a mantle this young child had on, with brooches and ringers full richly bedone. He had a suit of Eastern silk about his middle drawn, and if he lacked in courtesy, he thought of it much shame. Godspeed thee, King Arthur, sitting at thy knee, and the goodly Queen Guinevere, I cannot her forget. I have with me a mantle no lady can resist, but it shall ne'er become that wife who hath once done amiss. For if she be unfaithful, tatters it shall fall, and if she be but honest, she'll brighten any hall. And first there came Queen Guinevere, for she should lead the way, and she was surely in great doubt, although she would not say. And then she took the as if she'd been a maid, and sullenly from top to toe it loosely fell in shreds, and then it colored brightest red, and then it colored green, and then it colored darkest black, so ill did her be seen. And then forth spoke King Arthur, the angrier he grew, by all the knights of England, I fear thou be not true. And she threw down the mantle and winked through the court to see, and blushed as red as roses, and to her room did flee. Sir Kay called forth his lady, bid her to come here, and said, if thou be guilty, I pray thee only there. And so forth came his lady, so bold she did appear, and likewise was embarrassed, and cried for all to hear. And likewise all the thought their wives most true, commanded them to try it on, so bitterly did rue. And then there came a faded knight, Sir Cradock was his name, and all the kings of Arthur's court of him had sport and game. And when this mantle shall all be thine, and if thou ever did amiss, the shame is therefore mine. The lady took the mantle and cast it her about. Bow down to me, good mantle, and shame me not for now. For once I did, I'll tell thee certainly, for once I lay in Craddock's bed before he married me, when she had made confession and all her sins atoned. The mantle stood about her, in bright array she stood, so seemly of color, glittering of gold. Then all the knights of Arthur's court her beauty did behold. So Craddock stood was The Boy in the Mantle, Child Ballad number 29. The next three ballads, including this one, actually were not folk ballads like the rest of them, but written by actual minstrels. So as you can see, this is a King Arthur story, and it's a bit fun. It's a bit long, but I like it. Alan Taylor did this version, and I thought it was the nicest, so see ya!